What does it take to rebuild your life
after making all the choices that you shouldn't have, after having turned everything upside down? And is there any way to rebalance the scales and ever find a center that isn't reactionary in order to make life meaningful again? Life has a way of throwing us into chaos, especially when we have a propensity to sweep the leg and yank the tablecloth out from under everything. This isn't a conversation about regret or wallowing in the past. It's about rebuilding, recalibrating, finding a path forward with purpose and clarity. Because if you're anything like me and you've had yourself in this kind of a situation, then you know what the idea of a ripple effect is. And you can relate to how important it is to those of us trying to regroup and rebuild after self-destructive choices. There's no blueprint. There's no guide. All that's left is you and the rest of your life figuring out how to carry the wake of destruction while doing everything you can not to allow all of that to define you. And in knowing that, then figuring out how to move on while carrying it and doing what you need to do to make sure that you don't fall into the same kind of trap that you know you have a propensity to fall into. So let's look at it. Let's figure it out. Because all we have left is this burden and time. We owe it to ourselves and we owe it to the people that we care about the most to put our best foot forward. And what wasn't easy to do before, now we have to do it and carry whatever destruction guilt we will carry. So how do we do that? How do we carry all of that without letting it define us, without it taking more from us than it needs? How do we rebalance the scales when we're driven by our desire to overcompensate for our past discretions? How do we find the center that we need to live meaningfully again? I'm talking about carrying my responsibility. I want to carry my responsibility. Part of the process into moving into what you're intended to be is you taking accountability of your opportunity, owning the damage and learning from it. Choosing growth over guilt is a daily choice. That's part of it. It doesn't magically disappear. It won't. Unless you experience something miraculous, you are going to live every day with the choice of guilt or growth. And if you're anything like me, then you're all right with taking responsibility for yourself. Carry your own. You're striving not to be weak. You're striving to deal with it. You're striving to harden up. You're trying to rebuild yourself, rebuild your thinking. You're using that foolishness as grit to inform your determination of where you don't want to ever go again. You want to be terrified of that. You want to let that drive you where you're an example for yourself and for anybody that comes into your proximity. The onus is on you. You can hand it away, or you can harden yourself up and get to the business of carrying your burden. That doesn't mean you're carrying it alone. God's right there with you. Your friends are right there with you. Your family's right there with you. The people that care about you are right there with you. And I'm right there with you right now, just like you're right there with me. Everything better that I am is a slingshot out of the stupidity. They say equal and opposite reaction. So allow me to be as great as I have been terrible. All of this, it begins with self-awareness and accountability. As I mentioned before, part of my effort to be more accountable is this daily discussion where I lay it out on the table in a public way in order to attest for what I intend to be, that I have you there to hold me to account, to hold me to what I am saying at this position in my life today going forward. It's a weapon of influence that I'm applying onto myself. Because when you have driven the ship into stormy water against all better judgment, and the responsibility for the resulting catastrophe lays squarely in your hands, your only choice left is stabilizing that ship, regardless of the rough seas. It's your duty. It's your opportunity. It is meeting yourself. Assess your situation. Look for the damage. Adjust yourself accordingly before you plot a new course. Going forward, how do you carry the weight of the past mistakes without them defining you when they do? How do you keep that from defining your future when it precipitates it? Acknowledging your mistakes can feel heavy, but carrying them doesn't mean that they have to drag you down. Your past actions are lessons. They're not life sentences. The key is to embrace accountability while separating your identity from those mistakes. You are not your failures. You are the person choosing to move beyond them. There's an interesting metaphor that I've read before. It talks about a backpack full of rocks being an analogy for the burden of what it is that you're carrying. Each mistake represents a rock. And as you unpack each one through reflection and accountability, the load that you're carrying becomes more manageable. So if you're ready to make progress in a more constructive trajectory, you're probably asking yourself, what steps can you take to find new purpose when the path isn't clear? Finding your purpose when a path isn't clear, finding the steps to take when you can't see your way, can be overwhelming, can be disheartening, especially when you have resolved yourself to making the adjustments that you need to, but with the path obscured, you're not able to make a progress that you'd like to be able to feel like you are being constructive and taking action. But remember, all of that's an intention. And clarity comes from small, intentional actions rather than waiting for a perfect moment or revelation. Purpose is something we build. It isn't something we stumble onto. You can start by identifying one action that you can take today, whether it's taking steps to mending a relationship, pursuing a goal, or simply practicing self-care. Self-awareness and accountability are two equal parts that you need to focus on to be able to forge a path. And that's because self-awareness helps you to identify the patterns that either lend to something positive and constructive or to lead to something unwanted and destructive. And accountability ensures that you stay in line with your chosen goals and values. Applying these two functions is similar to assembling a puzzle. You don't necessarily need to see the big picture all at once to be able to start finding pieces that work together and staying on the task of doing so. There can be beauty in everything. This walking here and talking with you, I just happened to think about the story of the rose and the concrete. I was just thinking about what exactly I was going to say next, and I thought about the idea of finding beauty in the darkness, and I second-guessed myself when I thought that at first I didn't want to make an implication of celebrating darkness, but then that story of the rose and the concrete popped into my mind and give me the license to go ahead and lean into that a little bit. And if you're not familiar, it's just a metaphor to say, here is something ugly, and in all of the ugly, there's something beautiful. But I want to tell you that every day I deal with the reality of the chaos that I created. Every day lives in the wake of that. There is no way back to before that. There is no memory wipe. No matter how many times you try to hand it off to God, you still are carrying that. Maybe that's God's way of showing you his expectation that you'll start carrying yourself. Maybe God would rather see you start to stand up and carry yourself, or at least try to, or at least go through the process that looks like that's what you're trying to do. And it might sound harsh, but I'm talking to myself. But I want you to know clearly that I'm talking to myself. And if you're anything like me, go ahead and let it sink in too, because I'm living in the wake of it. And it's nothing that I'm romanticizing. It's just nothing I can escape. And whenever I brought the problems into my life, by allowing myself to be so helpless and so angry, then I took responsibility. There was no one else. It was all my own doing. I threw the handbrake. I caused it to derail. I destroyed the idealism, and I destroyed the joy of the people that I should have been protecting the most. And anything that I do from that point on, even positive, it's a better direction than the other choice. But it's only birthed out of self-loathing, and all of that I have to carry. And if you're anything like me, then you have to carry what it is that you're responsible for. And what we have to hope for and how we can hope to atone is illustrated in the rose and the concrete. Maybe there's something useful to somebody in some part of this. And as terrible and unromanticizable as that value is, it is at least better than further in the other direction. So before you can begin to atone for yourself, before I can begin to atone for myself, I need to have taken intention, and I need to have woven it into the fabric of my being. I need to lay the pavestones of my future out of the resolve before I can go face to face. And that's where I'm at. And I don't know where you are, and I don't mean this to be heavy. It's heavy as it is. I celebrate where I'm at. Not in the sense that I'm glorifying myself, anything that I do, but I celebrate it because as stupid as I have allowed myself to be, to go as far down into the depth before having any good sense to think about moving in the other direction, finally did change course, finally did move in another direction. And I've spent the better part of the last 10 years doing my best to adapt to a refocused purpose and the actuality of delicacy of the balance. So I don't know that there's ever an exact way to regain it. And regardless of whether or not I can regain any balance, I am going to meet myself. And if that's the best that I can hope to expect, then you can believe that I'll meet that purpose. Because for me and my understanding, that's how I atone. So whatever it is that you're getting to and you're trying to do and you're trying to build, wherever you're at it. Keep your head up. I'm going to keep my head up. We'll keep working towards it because that's all we have. We'll talk again soon.